Joe's in the hospital.
Joe?
No, Joe.
Joe.
Joe Green.
No, Joe.
What is it, Chief?
Joe Green is in the hospital.
Yeah, I was just telling you how they read it.
Yeah, too bad.
Too bad it wasn't fatal. It could have been with the right kind of workman.
I've got to interview. I've got the telephone.
Mr. Green, you can't phone anyone, Dr. Gould.
I must. I can do just once.
Green, you're a very sick man.
I promise to obey all your orders from now on. If you'll just let me talk to Johnny Cagney. I must, I tell you, it's urgent.
Very well. Just this one call, but not more. Plug in the telephone for Mr. Green. Department of Weights and Measures. Oh, yes, Mr. Green. Oh, Mr. Green. I'm positive he isn't in because there was a call from Mr. Cage just a minute ago from the city prosecutor. Yes, Mr. Green. As soon as he comes in, I'll tell him you want him. Yes, I will. And take care of yourself. And don't worry. Hello. Have you located Mr. Cage? Well, please keep trying. I'll call back later. Where is Mr. Cage? 212, second floor. Thank you. Dr. Richards, please. First hall to the right, third door. Information desk. Yes, Dr. Richards, she's on her way up now.
Pardon me. Can I see Joe Green, please?
Sorry, but Mr. Green is not permitted to have visitors.
Well, in the meantime, Johnny Cave called.
Mr. Cave? Oh, I've been trying everywhere, Mr. Cave. Please go right up. Mr. Green is in room 612.
612? Thank you.
So, just another order. I'm telling you, Johnny, I was crossing the car tracks. Suddenly, the yard of the beaver ahead of me stopped. I can't find my brakes. The machine ahead started away just as the streetcar hit.
When I came to, I recalled the face. One of the men in the car ahead looked back just before the crash.
You recognize him?
I think it was again.
Cavanaugh.
Yeah, Marty Cavanaugh.
I never met that mother. But I'm going to make it my business to go for long.
You're no luck with the professor. Remember, you're in the Department of Weights and Measures.
I'd like to take his measure.
I'm going to be a chance. But the department wants evidence, not protocols.
They tell me I'll be here for weeks.
I'm going to make you chief deputy.
Me?
Yeah. In my place. I know I can depend on you, John.
Thanks, Mr. Green. Glad you think so.
Remember now, keep your head on your shoulders and your fists in your pockets.
Yeah, I'll be some.
That's it. That's Cavanaugh's plenty of acres.
I'll take all the bite out of him. And our troubles will be over, huh?
Cavanaugh's just a preliminary. The main batch yet to come. It's up on higher up. I wish I'd hear.
We don't think this time is up, Mr. Green. So just leave him. Well,
I remember, Johnny. Don't let that fist drift against anybody's chin.
But don't worry. It won't. You'll be able to play that next time I see you.
Goodbye. Goodbye, sir.
Luncheon date, babe.
When? And with whom?
Today, with the guy you want to marry. Remember?
Name, please. Oh, Johnny Cave. Well, of course. A great guy. He told me so himself.
You wouldn't doubt him, would you? Same place, 12:30. And don't be late.
What? Me late? Well, I'm like that of all the nerves. What are you talking about? I'm usually the one that has to stand around waiting 20 minutes for you to show up.
All right. But you heard me. Don't be late.
No, I just had to.
I'm just mentioning that Joe Green while he's in the hospital. Now, you know, without my mentioning any names, who put him there. And why? Because he wouldn't take orders from anybody except people who trusted him. He knew what it meant to keep the housewife. Of course, it doesn't sound like much, chiseling just a few ounces of meat on the pound or a few potatoes out of a sack. But understand this. 40% of the American income is spent on food. And if people are cheated out of only 5%, in 1 year, that adds up to more than a war debt. Now, it's a big job. It's a big racket we're fighting. People on the other side of the fence have a great deal at stake. And they want to make it very tough for them. So if there are any of you who are a little bit afraid to tackle it, now's the time to fall. Thanks. That makes it unanimous. Now, here's a neat little gadget. And one of the latest. Here we have a 2 pound weight. You put on the scale. It still weighs 2 pounds. But watch the hand. Very tough on the housewife. You'd be surprised. The name of some of the stores has to be brought boots to advantage. Very delicate point. Practically every time you make a pinch, you're going to be offered a bribe. Now, some deputies have taken bribes. That's your answer.
Around to all the newspapers to see if they knew that you were the new chief deputy.
Mm-hmm. Where are you from?
Well, I was born on the Great Basket Island off the southwest coast of Ireland. But I lived most of my boyhood in a little bit of a village outside of Falsbourn, County of Mayo. Mm-hmm.
Not the type of the kosher markets. I think I'm going to take you myself. Well, if you don't mind, I'll just go to your Aloysius. This is it. A lot of complaints about this one.
Oh, well, I wish I think I'd buy some strawberries.
How much are they?
25 cents.
Well, are they fresh?
Fresh. And every berry is big for a size.
Mm-hmm. Take a box.
Yes.
You know, there's a saying in Ireland that it's all right to pick the berries, but you must never, never cut down the tree. Because under the vines, you have all the good berries. And if you cut down the vines, you do away with their power to do good for you. Hmm?
That's very interesting.
But there are no strawberries in Ireland.
Oh, no, I could swear I saw some of the country.
I think I'll buy 5 pounds of sugar. Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
5 pounds of sugar, please. How much of that?
8 cents.
There you are, even money. Well, Aloysius, what do you want for supper?
Oh, I don't know. Supper would stick to you, but I've got an appetite for corned beef.
And I've got a reason for chicken.
How about nice stewing chicken? About 6 pounds.
Okay.
There you are, 6 pounds right on the head. Wrap it up. Let me see it.
I love this man.
And then just laid it.
What's the idea? You can. Oh, Mr. Reedy,
Mr. Reedy. Very cute. Balls and the sawdust make no noise at all.
Not bad, not bad.
What is it? What is it?
They poisoned.
Well, how do you suppose those got there?
Your guess is as good as mine. Let me have that sugar. I paid for
it. I can't understand, Brent.
We'll do our best to help you. Let's go, Kelsey.
You haven't missed any bets, have you? How about buying that bird back for $50?
Oh, it'd be a waste of money. He spoiled by the time he got out of jail.
Hold on to that other wishes. That's evidence.
It'll not leave my hands.
Time of your life. Yeah, now hold on to that. And another move out of you and I'll pin your ears back. Yes, sir. Fill it up. Five. Yes, sir.
Did I never tell you about the giant causeway? There were big giants in Ireland, so big, they stood on the top of mountains and they threw hills at each other. Mm-hmm. And then there were the leprechauns. Little people, no bigger than your tongue, and you could see them walking around.
Mm-hmm. And my grandmother used to tell me about Lucifer the devil, who had one big me and one little me. You ever see that?
Awesome.
That'll be 93. This is a company call. I need a receipt. Okay, just a minute. It's our last job before lunch. I've got to make for my girl.
Take it to the Echo Cafeteria. It's a new
one. I've got a chance to go to the Ritz today. This is a celebration. An event.
I see.
Did you have in there?
Not a drop. The car's tank is divided inside. You want to run on, and you have to know your 5 gallons.
Oh.
That's what I thought. A little over 4 gallons. And that. You were warned about this violation last summer. Now you're doing summer. Oh, wait a minute, fellas. Wait a minute. Listen. Can I give you the fine and save me the trouble of going downtown? Oh, come on, what about $20?
Save it, you need it for the fine. Put a tag on that phone for me.
Did you break your pen?
No. Promise.
We got a check for $1,000 for the midnight mission. Mail it right away.
Thanks again, Mr. Kennedy.
Well, not at all. My pleasure. Goodbye, Mr. Marvin.
Oh, Mr. Kennedy, would it be all right if I attended this after lunch? I have a date with my boyfriend.
Of course.
Oh.
How long? Check and wait.
Thank you, sir. Dave, dear, you're 5 minutes late, honey.
Oh, you're very lucky. I've kept others waiting for days.
Well, anytime you want to go back to those others. Perfectly all right with me.
My best friend gets hit by a streetcar, winds up in the hospital, civil war in Spain, earthquakes in Japan, and now you wear that hat.
What's the matter with this hat?
It embarrasses me.
Embarrasses you? Wait, if I like it, and I like it. Where shall we eat?
We'll go to the Ritz.
We're not going to the Ritz. We're going someplace that fits our perks.
Sweetheart, this is a celebration.
We're not going to the Ritz?
Fine way to talk to the chief deputy.
We're not going to the Ritz.
For the first time since I've known you, you're going to do as I say. We're going to the Ritz.
thing. If you cheat weights and measures, pushing a tray.
Are you skipping that spinach?
I certainly am.
Another portion, I think.
Fine way to talk to a chief deputy. Say, would you care for some nice spinach for chief deputy?
What are you mumbling about? Hot roast.
No drinks in the hospital.
No.
What would it be like?
Oh, that's too bad. Are you being serious?
Serious enough to keep them there for several weeks.
Oh, I'll have to tell myself. Well, that puts you in charge.
Yeah.
Why didn't you tell me?
Oh, I just want to get out of the bedroom.
Jello. Two.
No jello.
No apple pie. Jello.
At the Ritz. It's so much more social here. That's very social.
I put your money in the bank yesterday.
Huh?
I've got a surprise. I picked out the winning one. Just a plain gold fan, but it's lovely.
I've got my eye on this one. I'm sorry, but it'll set us back when we
get just the bedroom set and all the kitchen furnishings. Now, we can't afford it, Johnny. I'll wait.
Now, since you're making those decisions, why do you want to make the leap?
I've been thinking about that, too. What are you saying? 3 weeks from Saturday.
3 weeks from Saturday? There's two more paydays. We'll be in swell shape.
Aren't you glad I made you save, Johnny? Now we have enough to furnish a cozy little apartment. Following the installment plan, but it's...
Oh, yes, don't... Installment plan? It's a racket.
With you, everything's fine. Everybody's a burglar, everybody's a crook. You don't believe in philanthropy, you don't believe in public spiritedness, you don't even believe in men like Mr. Canning.
What do I know about Mr. Canning? Is he your hopeless?
Oh, Johnny, you're hopeless. What would you do if I said Joel Green was a dishonest man?
You say you were cockeyed. Mm-hmm. He's honest and the day is long.
Well, that's just the way I feel about Mr. Canning, and I should know. I've been with him many years. I was with the firm years before he made me his private secretary.
All right.
Oh, Mr. Haley.
Yes, ma'am.
I wonder if I could have a little information for my private file.
Why, certainly.
Are you married?
Well, yes.
Any children? Oh, how silly.
Yes. I mean, do you want my number?
I've got your number.
You've got my...
Oh, Mr. Haley, I wonder if by any chance you happen to be going my way.
Well, which way are you going?
The only thing is, I live at 191st Street.
That's a very funny thing. I'm going within 2 blocks of it.
Oh, fine. Will you hold my hand, Mr. Haley?
Yeah.
Haley, that's such a lovely name. It has a certain ring to it.
Did I ever tell you the history of the Haley?
No.
You know, Charlemagne, the emperor of the whole West, he was the first Haley. And one of the kings of Ireland, he was a Haley. Do you know that I am the first son of the first son of the first son for 600 years straight down to...
Haley Selassie?
Yes.
Hey, it's 10 after 6 and we don't pay overtime.
Well, I'll see you tomorrow.
On time.
I'm always on time. Except when...
Good night, Aloysius.
Don't be working too hard, Johnny. I always say a fellow isn't happy unless he enjoys his work. And the only way to enjoy your work is to do it that is his love. Except, of course, in a case where you have something to do which you can't put up. In which case, you could always quit your job because you say...
Good night, Aloysius. Good night, Hazel.
Good night.
Take good care of yourself.
Don't worry about her. She knows all the answers.
Sure I do, if you'll stop talking long enough for me to use them.
You're Johnny Cagney, weren't you?
Yeah.
I'm Marty Cavanaugh, District
leader of the set. I figured we ought to be. We've got a lot of things in common.
How much you win, Mr. Cavanaugh?
Just playing Marty to you, Johnny.
What can I do for you?
Not a thing, kid. Not a thing.
Stop.
I came over here to do something for you. How about coming into my club? Our organization can use young fellows like you.
No, thanks. I don't think the boss likes us to belong to political clubs.
Well, you've got your own future to look out for. Why, you might get to be a district leader like me.
I couldn't dress the part.
We'll fix it so you can afford to dress this way.
Very nice.
Okay? A friend of mine spoke to me about you. He thinks very highly of your ability.
That's fine.
He asked me very particularly to do something for him. How about deputy leader at 200 a month? And that's just a start, you understand? Now listen, you can...
Just a minute.
What's on your mind? Well, I happen to have a summons here that you gave Edie in the Paradise Market. And you want me to forget? That's the idea. You do want something, and we'll cut you a nice little slice of cake.
No, thanks. I don't want some.
What are you being so noble about? Going around with a chip on your shoulder. Listen, this stuff is all unimportant. A grocer or a butcher charges a woman 3 or 4 cents more than she's supposed to pay. So what? She never misses it. Look, I'll show you what I mean. You got 3 pennies?
Come on.
Come on, give me, give me, give me. Now, just to prove that they don't mean a thing. See? You've lost 3 pennies. You don't miss it, do you? Well, that all depends. I'll show you what I mean. See? You lost a half. You don't miss it, do you? Now listen, Johnny. We can do things for you or to you. You mean you'll do to me what you did to Joe Green?
I'll take it easy.
Now listen. I'll tell you, he ain't for anybody who threatens my men or tries to send money up my desk for me. It's a one-way street, Cavanaugh. And if you start up, you want to meet me coming down.
Let him have it, boys. He couldn't miss it for reason.
Where do you think you're going?
I'm going your way.
No, he ain't. He's going our way.
That's right.
Just sit here and think. Try thinking, Red.
Are you trying to commit suicide? You don't mind if I stretch, do you?
Spread any for us. That's for some luck what's breaking the law.
Well, let me even. Come on, we roll.
I don't like that pity on you. Put this little lump on.
For what?
Put it on.
Who told you guys to do all this?
A little boy who came. The boy's black boy this spring. Get in there.
drunk. Why, you know that, I tell you that. Don't you see the liquor splashed all over him? Why, he's been drunk, but he's been right.
Sure.
You ain't for half as bad as I hoped you were.
Well, the bad guy is.
Red hair, wearing a bad overcoat, pulled up on him, and it's news to you, huh?
Yeah, that gun is found in your pocket.
Come on, say something.
What do you want me to say? I'm telling you, I was brave. They poured liquor all over my clothes, hit me over the head, left me lying in the gutter.
You said that 14 times.
I'll say it 14 more.
Ah, we're getting nowhere fast. Bring in the complainant.
Well, hello, Johnny. What are you doing here?
That's your man.
Is this the fellow supposed to have stuck me up?
Yeah.
Well, this ain't the guy.
Friend of mine.
How are you, Johnny?
What?
Sure, Johnny K, Chief Deputy of Weights and Measures.
What about the red hair and that coat?
Well, you can't arrest a guy for having red hair. Besides, that isn't the coat. The one the stick-up wore was an entirely different color.
How about this gun?
Well, Chief's got a permit, ain't you, Johnny?
You ought to quit wearing that coat, Johnny.
A coat like that is bound to get you in trouble. Should be a lesson to you.
This reminds me of the story of the guy who, right after the wedding, sacked his bride in a joke. Then he says to her, "That's for nothing. Now be careful."
You can't feel better?
Hot back.
Oh, good moment. You know, Johnny, in a way, it's your own fault. That chip on the shoulder comes. Now, you can't go around stepping on people's toes expecting to like it. You're too aggressive. That Irish.
What's the matter with the Irish?
I didn't say anything was the matter with the Irish.
You did, too.
I did not. There you go, scrapping at the first opportunity. There's no sense of trying to be nice to you. Let me tell you something, Johnny, please. If you don't want to let...
All right.
May I call your attention to this charming love scene?
Look, darling. I've got to be at the mayor's office in about 5 minutes. If you've got anything you like, I'm sure to get me something I can put my feet on. Bye.
What have you got for feet?
A footstool.
Cave.
Oh, Mr. Cave. I'm sorry, but his honor has been unavoidably detained. Won't you ever see him?
Can't wait. There are too many important calls to make.
Oh, Mr. Cave. His honor is very anxious to see you. Won't you please wait in here? His honor is on his way now to the new bridge. He made the dedication speech.
Who wrote it for him?
Oh, Mr. Cave.
Shows an increase of 53% in the number of arrests. I ascribe such a showing to your untiring efforts. It's superb.
Colossal.
Precisely. Now, we wish to reward you properly. We're appointing you to the Governor's Tax Commission as Special Investigator. The appointment carries a salary almost double your present.
It's very nice, Your Honor, but you see, I...
Now, as a much older man, one who's devoted most of his life
accept. We have great need of a man of your caliber, Mr. Cagney, the tax commissioner. Great need. As has often been said, necessity is
the mother of suspension.
Liberty, Mr. Cagney. Former taker, I think.
No, Your Honor. I'm very grateful for this opportunity, but I can't take it at this time.
I'm afraid this position can't wait.
My fears are trying to be subtle. I should leave myself. Now, look. I'm staying in the department, and there's not going to be any fix. I know I'm treading a lot of toes in this organization, and I also know that the boys want me out of the way.
That's a bold statement, Mr. Cagney. I'm sure you don't mean it.
I mean it. You can tell Mr. Marty Cavanaugh, who instructed you to call me, that I said so.
Are you suggesting that Mr. Cavanaugh dictates the policy of this office?
What do you think?
Get Abel Cagney on the phone. Swell-headed top maker. Definitely dangerous. Must be stopped.
Never mind. We'll find a way.
How about 18 holes in the morning?
Right.
As I say, the sudden notice of my maneuvers came as a great shock. It leaves me with a very helpless feeling after. After all my years of service.
I'm afraid you objected a bit too strenuously, Mrs.
Mr. King, we were being cheated. And for a long time, the deliveries were always far short of what we were compelled to sign for.
There seems to be a bit of a difference, Mrs. Ogilvie, between the items we've seen it for and those delivered.
At least 50%. Of course, there always is.
Why'd you sign this?
Not me, Sawyer. Before I get my job,
Sawyer will give you a chance to think it over in a cage.
And it goes for you, too.
Don't sign with an X.
I paid Cagney this morning, and it's fixed money. I ain't spoken, you understand? I want to
Why, congratulations, you lucky stiff.
Well, Janet, watch me a friend of mine. This is Pete Riley. Used to be the head of business.
Yes. Mr. Red Samples. Pleased to meet you. Got the finest guy in shoes.
I think so.
See, I'm throwing a big party tonight, Mr. Quillian.
I got a whole floor to hand the cage to the butlers.
I want you both to come.
Oh, it's going
to
be a swell blowout.
I'm going to fancy trimmers. I'm going to make a speech, too.
I wouldn't miss that. What do you say, Don?
Thank you, Mr. Riley. We'll be there.
Great. 9:30.
So long, old Palooka.
Let's give you dinner. I got $1,000 worth of fancy grub coming up.
Bye. He made a speech on the radio once.
Speech on the radio?
Yeah, he said, Ma. It was a good fight. I'm glad I won.
My second told me about that.
Well, I'm glad you're not crying for anything anymore. Listen, Johnny, about that job with Mayor.
Maybe it's only for me.
You know I'm glad that I can.
Well, if I prove to you that this boss of yours is not the shining example of what you're supposed to be, will you give me something for me?
Judge, how could you suggest such a what's wrong with... Oh, Mr. Cagney, this is Mr. Cagney.
Mr. Cagney, of the Department of Weights and Measures. Well, I'm delighted to meet you.
Thank you.
Will you come in?
I don't hold you up, Mr. Kenny, if you go someplace.
Not at all. Glad to have a chat with you.
Sit down.
Thanks. His Honor, the mayor, we played golf yesterday. You sort of put him in the spot with the governor. Really? Yes, indeed. He promised the old boy he could deliver just the man he wanted, and well, you tracked him down, Kolker.
Oh, I'm sorry. We upset any of his plans.
I believe you're making a big mistake. My long experience puts me off of my advice. Of course, you can take it or leave it as you see fit, but I do believe you should give this opportunity further consideration. It is an opportunity, Mr. Cage, believe me, and one that might open the door, so to speak, to a very bright future. What do you say?
You really think I ought to do it?
I do indeed. Let me give the story of your acceptance to the papers.
Let me give it to you. I want to congratulate you, Mr. Kelly, on your kindness to charity. It's great about your latest gift. Murphy, please. Murphy, Johnny K. of your Weights and Measures. Say, I've got a pimp for a story we've had from an edition. Huh? Well, here's your headline. Abel Canning steals bread from Wilder City's orphans. Collection of supplies he never delivered. Send a couple of men over to my office in about 20 minutes.
You wouldn't dare.
I'm going to be going, Kenny. You've got the point.
You go through with that tape, you'd wish you never were born.
I'll see you in jail, Brent Snatcher.
How dare you talk like that, Mr. Kenny?
Why do you hear the prosecuting attorney have to say to
me? Now listen here, Johnny.
Get out of this, will you? I'm giving you the affidavits this afternoon. So long.
I'm terribly sorry, Mr. Kenny.
Don't be sorry for me. It's the young man who will suffer. If he gives his blackmailing scheme to the papers, I'm going to have to do a thing. Public opinion will force him out of office. He'd be lucky if he escapes a jail sentence.
Johnny, you're wrong, I tell you. You don't know Mr. Canning like I do. He's a fine man. Well, he's done everything for me. Put me through business college, gave me this job. Why, he's been like a father to me. No, Johnny, you're mistaken. Well, don't do anything I can't forgive you for.
You won't have to forgive me for anything, baby. I know what I'm doing. I've got... That story?
You bet. Print it.
Thanks, Lexus. Okay.
Johnny.
Send down all the papers on the Canning case right away.
Just a moment, please. Mr. Cave, the prosecutor's office wants the evidence on the Canning case. Shall I take the papers down?
Come on, bring them down myself.
Mr. Case says he'll bring them down himself in about 2 minutes.
Thank you. Anybody ask me what happened?
All right, Mr. Case.
Nice work, Burton. Bring him over here right away.
Thinking things over, Mr. Canning. I made a bad deal. $500 ain't enough for them papers. They're worth a lot more to me.
Do what you say about $5,000? $5,000? You weren't taking any chances. Not with me behind you. But you're taking chances now.
Yeah?
I'll get a load of this. I'm not going to have one of them sudden accidents. Because I'll call him and tell the city prosecutor what the papers are.
Now, it doesn't interest me, Mr. Kennedy. It's $5,000, or I'll peddle them papers someplace else.
Find anything yet, Pat? I gave all the description I could. But it all happened so quickly, I'm not completely dizzy. Still dizzy. You do whatever you think best. As far as I'm concerned, you're the police department. You keep digging through those pictures, and I'll be down for a while. Yeah. At a time like this, you're right like that.
It's worse than that,
Joe. What's this?
Your bank book. All your savings are there. It's your department, not anymore.
Oh, darling, you don't
mean... I mean, we're through. Finished. Mr. Reese, listen, you've got to write me down in the papers. I've written to enough. It's no use to you.
You paid me.
I paid you not. But you wouldn't listen. You never listen. You're arrogant. You're stupid. We could never be happy together. I love you, but I'm going to get up. And you... And... Well, so... I don't ever want to see you again.
How about this guy?
No.
Here's a big baby. There's the guy, Pat. You're like a boxcar. Mm-hmm.
Joe Burton, alias Belden. Alias Bilkowitz, ex-wrestler, 4 convictions.
Maybe the edge of the moment's crack. Get this guy. Hold on, let's see.
Well, we gotta get Charlie and Joe, a couple of pigeons, a car. Take all of 20 minutes. Charlie, listen. You haven't got a thing on me, Hanlon, and you know it. You got a lot of cross pitching me and
sprung out of this trap in 5 minutes. Plenty of time. Telephone girls will be out all night. You don't remember strong-arming this fellow this afternoon and stealing his papers. I never monkey with kids. Take it easy, Johnny. He and Thorner will keep him here till Christmas. Hmm. 6 tickets for Marty Cavanaugh's political jamboree in the moonlight. Marty, a friend of yours? Anyway, what about it? Nothing. Mike, take him downstairs a while. He's tired. He needs a little rest. You can't do this to me, Hanlon. I tell you, I've got an important date. That's all. Mike, on the way down, tell Mr. Burton the story of the lifers that wanted to know what time it was. Go on. Did you see how much singing that canary did?
Yes, I did. Well, anyway, we've got to the club address. I'll let you get a quick frisk.
I was coming to that. This is the only key here. Look at that. Mother must have given him that to tease on.
Well, thanks, Pat.
Take it easy now, Johnny. I'll be sure to examine the drain pipes under the sink.
Can't fool me. I'll even look under his pillow.
Good luck.
There aren't going to be any ifs or buts about it. I want Joe Burton released at once.
Well, I'll see what I can do about it.
You'll see about nothing. You'll do it.
Okay.
Roger, get me Captain Hanlon on the phone. I haven't got anything on him anyway.
I let Burton go. Orders from the boss.
Oh, that's all right.
I just want Burton. I want those papers.
Think Burton still have
them? Certainly, that's when they got him out of here.
That's right. I'd like to give that mug another working over for the way he bawled me out in the leg. Said he hardly had time to get his mat scraped and massaged. Going to that big blowout Pete Riley's given tonight.
Burton's going to Marty's party?
Said he has an invite.
So am I. I've just got time enough to get my glad bags on myself. I'd like to get.
Look out, Johnny. Burton's tough. I found that out.
I'm not usually dancing. I'm sitting here decorated.
Thank you. I'm waiting for Mr. Parker to be back. Won't you sit down?
Say, what's this run around you giving my pal?
Mr. Riley, I'm not giving anybody run around. I'm just sitting here minding my own business.
I get it. You want me to mind mine? But this is my party, and I want everybody to be happy, especially you and Johnny.
Well, if you don't mind, I'd rather not discuss it. Besides, I don't think you'd understand.
Fox boy gets the picture, you don't understand, Johnny. Don't you read the papers? This guy's in a jam. See all that beef on the boat?
It was in the heart of the tunnel. With him on it was on this side, a leopard on the other. At my heels was a tiger, and right in front of me was a roaring lion. Well, I was in a pretty bad way.
But what happened?
What happened? I was killed.
Oh, Mr. Canning, I'm surprised to see you.
When you gave me the invitation, Pete, I thought you meant it.
Sure, I did. You're as welcome as the flowers in July. Come on, I'll stick around and introduce you to some of the models.
Oh, don't bother. I'll find my way around.
Okay, find yourself a spot to dance with. I'll see you later. If you want a drink, flag a butler.
One minute. May I see you a minute?
Yeah, sure. That's my bank.
No part of your nose, will you?
I'll be right back. Have you heard him?
No, I'll be right here by this.
You all right?
Yeah.
Nothing to it.
Hello, Mr. Cagney.
Good.
I'd like to know Mr. Parker. This is my boss, Mr. Cagney.
Delighted, Mr. Parker. You're in very good company. I agree with you.
Thank you.
Wait a minute.
Hey. What happened to that big mug with the blown fluff?
You don't mean that guy that's been watching us down my heels all day, do you?
Yeah. See him?
I'm waiting.
You can't scan me, can you? It's $5,000 or no papers, and that's fine.
So hold on.
Yeah. What do you call that little
trick you have me?
Don't think I carry $5,000 around in my pocket.
I'll take a check made out of cash for the key to my apartment. That'll make it a legitimate business.
Not that it makes any difference to me. Did you find anybody here?
No.
Did you find him back again?
I'll find him, all right. I'll just keep right off my pocket money.
I'll see you.
Let me go up first.
Thank you.
shot of scotch. One for me, too.
That's right. You take care, will you, Alex? Explain tomorrow, and I'll see you later.
Yes,
I was simply telling the girl. Excuse us. Yes. You keep your eye on Britain. Tell him I'm not doing Marty. I'm going to bring the plot. Tell him that he has to wait.
Excuse me.
What's your name?
I beg your pardon. You're a friend of Johnny Cage.
I'm proud of him. I'm proud of the girl he's going to marry.
I hope so. Has he gone out?
No, he's gone out looking for better trouble.
He has a date with her. Mr. Cagney. That's Mr. Burton's apartment. Which reminds me, I have a date with Mr. Burton. Excuse me.
Hello, police headquarters. And let me speak to Mr. Hanlon, please. Oh, well, Captain Hanlon, then. Just say a friend of Johnny Cage's.
He ran the door.
Wouldn't it be just too bad if you were found here stiff and cold, shocked by committing burglary? You haven't got time enough to use that rod on me, Cavanaugh.
Funny, I thought I had.
Take care of it. The left will get rid of you.
Reilly.
like, I'm afraid we'll have to arrest Mr. Cavanaugh.
I'm afraid so.
Firebug in a high hat.
Everything all right, Johnny?
Yeah.
Kind of toasting around the edges, but it's all here.
I'm afraid we'll have to arrest you for, what'll it be, Johnny?
Oh, attempted arson.
Well, that'll do for now.
You can't arrest me. Let me have that phone
call. Oh, no, it wouldn't be fair to Mr. Burton. He'd have to pay for the call. I'll send a man to pick him up. I think we'll have a little get-together, and Pete Reilly may send some sandwiches. Take good care of Mr. Canning, Mike. And don't bend him. Well, let's get going. Come on, Marty.
Gee, wait a minute. Let me out of here.
Open that door, Johnny.
Now you're going to get what's coming.
You can't hit me. I'm under arrest.
Oh, no.
Come on, Johnny. Open this door. Open this door. You can't beat up my neighbor.
Johnny, you didn't use the money we'd saved.
Oh, of course not.
Yeah. Keep yourself. It's all intact.
How did you get the ring?
Bought it, of course.
But how?
On the installment plan.
But what about...
I know. It's a racket.
But Johnny... May I call your attention to this charming love scene?